farmer takes the wife. Hi-yo, the cheerio, farmer takes the wife.
Mr. Hooper.
Hello.
Have you seen Brother Kirk around?
Who?
Brother Kirk. We were going to sing some songs today.
Oh, Brother Kirk. Yes. Yeah. Right through the store into the army. Say a prayer with the children.
Oh, okay.
Hi, all the time.
Hi.
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 How you doing?
I'm sorry I'm late, Brother Kirk.
Oh,
hi, Bob.
Hi, Pete. Nice to see you again. Hey, look who we've got around. Good friend, Pete.
Think maybe we can sing a song?
Oh, yeah. Hey, kids, would you like to sing some songs with Pete?
Yeah!
All
right.
Hey, why don't somebody come up here? We can all sing, Pete. What are we going to sing, Pete?
Ooh, let me see if I can sing you a song you haven't heard before, but maybe you can still help me out. Here's one. There once was a man and he was hot, and he jumped into a coffee pot. The coffee pot was so high, he jumped into a piece of pie. The piece of pie, it was so thick, he jumped into a walking stick. The walking stick, it was so narrow, he jumped into a wheelbarrow. The wheelbarrow begun to crack, he jumped onto a horse's back. The horse's back began to break, he jumped into a chocolate cake. The chocolate cake became so rotten, he jumped into a bag of cotton. The bag of cotton caught on fire, blew him up to Jeremiah. Poof! Well, you could sing it with me. You could sing it with me if you just remember the rhyme on each verse. Which word rhymes with the other word?
All right.
There once was a man and he was hot. He jumped into a coffee
pot.
You got it. You got it? The coffee pot, it was so high, he jumped into a piece of
pie.
Piece of pie, it was so thick, he jumped into a walking
stick.
The walking stick, it was so narrow, he jumped into a
wheelbarrow.
The wheelbarrow began to crack, he jumped onto a horse's
back.
The horse's back began to break, he jumped into a chocolate
cake.
The chocolate cake became so rotten, he jumped into a bag of
cotton.
The bag of cotton caught on fire, blew him up to Jeremiah.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, 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 no, no, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11,
12,
13,
14,
64, 27,
15,
16, 17,
18,
19,
20. Hello there. Now, today we're going to talk to you about the difference between light and heavy. And in order to do that, I've prepared a little demonstration here. You will notice that I've got two bowls here in front of me. Now, this bowl over here is filled with light, fluffy feathers that Big Bird donated to us. On the other hand, this bowl right here is filled with big, round rocks that Oscar found for us, matter of fact. Now, in order to show you about light and heavy, I will lift up this bowl here. Now, when I lift the bowl of feathers, it's very lightweight. You see that? It's very easy for me to lift up that bowl. On the other hand, if I lift up this bowl of rocks, now it's... You can see that's a very heavy bowl. And it's not very easy for me to lift up that bowl at all. Now, furthermore, to explain a little bit more, if I lift up a feather, and if I drop it to the floor, it falls down very gently. See, wasn't that nice? On the other hand, if I lift one of these here rocks, now, this rock is very heavy, and it's going to fall to the floor with a loud thump, like so. Oh! Yes, it landed right on my finger there, too. Hello there, sir.
Cookie!
Oh, no. No, these are not cookies at all.
No?
Absolutely not. No, these right here are rocks, you see.
Rocks?
Yes, they're rocks, and they're very heavy.
Eat one?
You want to eat a rock?
Yeah, eat rock.
Oh, I don't think so. No,
oh, please.
No. People don't eat. People don't eat rocks.
Monsters eat rocks.
They do.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
I don't think that. Good heavens.
That was delicious. One more.
You're going to eat another of those rocks, but I don't really think that you should be eating rocks. There, it's a.
More.
No, rocks are very bad for you.
Good for monster.
No, I think they're. My goodness gracious! It's a. Sort of a heavy meal he's eating there.
Oh, boy. Look at that big one.
Listen, you're going to...
Last one.
But you're eating every last one of my rocks there. And...
Delicious. Thank you.
Monster, you ate all of my rocks.
Yeah.
Now, I don't think I even want you around here. Now, just leave, monster. Get on out of here.
I'm sorry. Thank you.
Yes, now just go.
Bye-bye.
Just go. I said go. Leave, vamoose, scram, skedaddle.
No, I can't go, too heavy.
You're too heavy?
Too heavy.
You mean you ate all those rocks and it made you so heavy you can't even move?
Oh, you're so right.
Oh, come on, monster. Now get up here where I can talk to you and stop looking at me through the bowl.
Keep pulling.
There.
Okay, there.
Now look what you just did. Now, I had this nice demonstration. I had two bowls. See that bowl there?
Yeah.
That bowl was full of nice round rocks. And you ate all my rocks. Now all I've got left are the feathers. Now what kind of demonstration can I do of light and heavy if all the rocks are gone? And now he's eating my feathers.
Feathers, yeah, now
Monster,
feathers.
What are you doing eating those feathers?
Oh, what? You see, monster eat heavy rocks. Oh, feather mouth. Monster eat heavy rocks.
Yes.
Get heavy.
You got heavy, and so?
So, monster now eat light feathers. Get light.
Say, Pete, sing a song for me, yeah?
Okay, we will.
Good.
Let's get Susan out here.
Hey, yeah, let's everybody shout for Susan.
All right.
Okay, let's see if she can hear us. Ready?
Susan!
One more time. Let's see if she can hear it. Come on.
Susan!
Hey, Deborah.
What? What's the matter? Oh, hi, Pete. Hi. Hi, brother. What's the matter, everybody?
We're going to sing you a song.
Oh, sing you a song. Okay, that's good.
We just called for you,
sorry.
Susan.
Yeah, I heard.
Did you heard us, huh?
Yes, indeed.
We're going to sing a song, about a man that perhaps none of you all ever heard of.
Who's that?
Benjamin Banneker. He's the son of an African prince. He self-educated himself and finally became one of the designers for Washington, D.C., and later drew the blueprint for Detroit, Michigan.
January 22nd. 1791, commission was given by George Washington. Place was to be selected, drawn out from A to Z, what turned out to be present-day Washington, D.C. Major Charles E. Fant was given the leading role. Due to disagreement, was dismissed from the fold. He was placed by Major Ellicott, and the maker of the first words clock. Benjamin Banneker was the man. Benjamin Banneker was the man, yes he was. Benjamin Banneker was the man. An expert mathematician, the best astronomist in this land. Benjamin Banneker was the man. On the walls of the White House, his armor neck still hangs, explaining the four seasons and the nature of changing things. Being a son of an African prince, to be a slave, he was never convinced. Benjamin Banneker was a man. Benjamin Banneker was a man, yes he was. Benjamin Banneker was a man. So when you think of the Capitol and the architects of plan, remember Benjamin Banneker was a man. He studied the Big Dipper and the Milky White Way. Why you plant peas in the middle of May? Why you plant watermelons during the month of June? And you could never plant turnip greens too darn soon. Benjamin Banneker was the man, Lord, Lord. Oh, Benjamin Banneker was the man. Benjamin Banneker was the man. So when you think of the Capitol and the architecture plan, remember, so Brother Benjamin was the man.
Hey, that's great.
Benjamin Banneker.
Oh. Open. Oh. Open. Open. Oh.
Oh.
Grow and go, roll over the road where the goat explodes all the O's and the crow flies low. Past the croaking toad and the boat floats over the ocean, but the wind did blow and it started to snow. So the toad went home to the telephone. He spoke to the goat who was eating a bowl of bones, potatoes and soap. A rope did float and hooked the goat, and a boy climbed the stone made of O's. The O's turned to smoke and started to float closer to the bulldozer, who closed up the hole so the cold wind could not blow. And the sun did show so the roses could grow, and the whole world would know that the boat bulldozer, the toad and the crow, the boy and the rope, right and the goat, were all okay. Okay.
Oh, hi. Herbert Birdsfoot here. I've just finished writing a beautiful poem, but I need someone to help me out, and I don't see anyone.
Hey, Herbie, baby!
Oh, hi, Grover.
Oh, Herbie, how are you?
Oh, just fine. How are you?
Oh, I am fine. It is good to see you.
Say, Grover.
What?
How'd you like to help me out with this beautiful poem I've just written?
I'd love to help you, Herb.
Oh, good.
Good. What do I do?
Well, all you have to do, really, is just one thing.
One thing?
Yeah, and that one thing is hop. Hop. Do you know how to hop?
No.
No?
No.
Well, do you know the word hop?
The word hop?
Yeah.
The word hop! Oh! No.
Well, look, down here we have an op.
Where?
Down here, Grover.
Oh, yeah.
An op.
Yeah.
You see, an O and a P together make the sound op.
Op, I know that.
Now, right. Well, to make the word hop,
yeah,
all we do is add an H on the front.
H?
Yeah, like that.
Oh, look at that, an H.
And an H sounds like this. That's the sound an H makes. Hop.
Op. That's nice.
Op.
That's nice. Op.
Now put it all together.
Yeah.
Hop.
Oh, hop.
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 There you
oh,
are.
Oh, that's nice. That right. is hop, huh?
Now,
oh.
right. Now, to hop,
how do I
all
hop?
You do is jump up and down on one foot, like this.
Do that
now
again.
You try.
Do
oh,
it again.
Okay.
Oh, that's nice. I'll
yeah,
try it.
Now you try.
Okay, one foot.
Right. Good.
Thank you.
That's right. That's very good. Now, the poem is about a man named Pop.
Pop.
Yeah. Now, that's another OP word.
Is it?
Yeah, another
there's
op.
There's the op
there's
down
the
there.
Op. That's right.
Yeah.
Now, this time we add a P, which sounds like
I knew
hey,
that.
You knew that
I
one.
Knew P. I help you, see?
Good, right.
There's the P
okay.
down there.
Now add that to the op.
Yeah.
Op.
Pop.
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 Right.
Right. Right.
Good.
I knew that.
Okay. Now, every time the man in the poem hops,
yeah.
I want you to hop, okay?
Every okay, now Herb,
yeah.
excuse me, but okay. I want to get this straight.
Right.
Every time the man in the poem, in the beautiful poem, hops.
Mm-hmm.
I hop.
Right.
Got it.
Okay, ready?
Right.
Here we go. There once was a man whose name was Pop, and all he ever did was hop.
Now, how about that?
That's fine, Grover.
Thank you.
But there's more.
Oh, Herb. I'm sorry. I did not know that. Herbie, I am so embarrassed. A little Herbie, you go ahead. Start over.
There once was a man whose name was Pop. The only thing he'd do was hop. All he ever did was hop. In fact, he'd never, ever stop. He went hop, hop, hoppity, hoppity, hop. Hoppity, hoppity, hop, hop, hop. Hop, hop, hoppity, hoppity, hop. Hoppity, hop, 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 hop. He went hoppity, hoppity, hop, hop, hop. Hop, hop, hoppity, hoppity, hop. Hop, hop, hoppity, hoppity, hop. Hoppity, hop, 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 hop.
Oh, Herb, is that all?
No, there's more.
Okay, only for you, Herb.
Okay. Hoppity hop hop, hoppity hop, hop hop hoppity, hoppity hop, hop hop hoppity, hoppity hop. You went hoppity hop 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 hop. Hey, that was very good, Grover, for a first time. Now let's do it again for real, okay?
Will you please assist me while I demonstrate?
Huh?
Pick this up, dum dum.
Oh, what? There.
That's right. Now that is the letter O.
Oh.
Correct. Now I'm going to recite a poem.
Oh?
Yes. The poem is about the letter called O, one of which you are holding there.
Oh.
Wonderful. A wonderful letter is O. It looks like a donut, you know. It has a round shape, like a ball or a grape, which makes it quite easy to throw.
Oh!
This your O? Oh.
Look over there between the buildings. The big white clouds.
Yeah.
Really
that's what I like about sunny days and when you can see the clouds and the sky's blue and everything.
Ever imagine?
Hey, what's all this neck stretching and pointing and stuff at here? What are you doing?
Oh, we're looking at the clouds.
Yeah, looking at the clouds.
Imagining what you can see in the clouds. Like,
yeah, that's right.
See a old man, long white beard.
Old man with a long white beard.
That looks like a tree.
Over on the right side there, yeah.
What does it look like?
Man with an old nose.
Yeah. And three people are jumping out. It's a private plane. Sorry. Well, and then three parachutes.
What does that look like to you?
I don't see that.
We're talking about the clouds.
I see an ice cream cone.
I think I see a banjo player up there.
Hey.
Where?
Right over there on the left-hand side.
Hi.
Oh, hi, Oscar. How are you?
What's everybody craning their necks for,
well,
looking up at the sky?
We're looking at those clouds over there, Oscar, and, you know, using our imagination.
Your imagination? What's
yeah,
that?
Yeah, we're seeing all kinds of different things in the
what
clouds.
What you think of, Oscar?
Yeah. Take a look and see what you imagine, Oscar.
Well?
Just look very closely and see all the different things you can see in those clouds.
Well, I see, I see some shapes. Look at that. The shape of that cloud looks a lot like, A boy stubbing his toe.
Oh, Oscar. You would think of something like that, Oscar.
That one up there looks like the Johnstown flood.
Oh, God.
Oscar,
it does not. Don't you see the old man with the beard over there, Oscar?
Yeah, I see an old man with a beard. He just, he stubbed his toe, too.
Oh, Oscar, I've got...
That one looks like the earthquake. 1906.
No. Oscar, people see all kinds of different things when they use their imagination, but yours are pretty grouchy, your imaginations, I must admit.
Oh, yeah. Hey, look at that one over there. Now, that one looks like a train wreck.
Oh.
Oh, come on. Oscar, that is nice.
Couldn't you think of one thing nice, Oscar?
What's nicer than a train wreck?
Oh.
I would like to think of some of the nice things that you can see in the sky.
Yeah, I would too. I think so.
Jingles of the wind is strumming against the sun. The magic sounds of music fills the air. Although you may not know me, I'll see you and then I'll love you when the morning comes again. Early in the morning, I stand up on the sea, gazing at reflections running wild. If I happen to capture my own, I'll sing a little song again. And I love you when the morning comes. again. I saw your eyes a-counting the stars up in the sky, although you had them closed when I was passing by. Thought I came to cause you pain, I came to do no harm. I love you when the morning comes again. I'm the song of the living, I'm the song of the dead. I can see you when you think you're all alone. I can sing a song of love that will cease the pounding rain. And I love you when the morning comes again. I can speak the tongue of a princess, and I can speak the song of a slave. And I can give a young child a dream to embrace. I can expand the universe with the thoughts inside of my brain. And I love you when the morning comes again. Now I must be leaving you, I must not lose the sky. The sun, moon, and stars must be my guide. You gave me your love without asking me my name. I love you when the morning comes again, again, again.
Oh, it's a lovely one, Chris. Wow.
Why? Yo-yo. Wow, 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 wow.
This is a letter. The letter Y. Do you know how I know? It looks like the trunk of a tree where the yellow yahoos go. Listen. Yahoo. There's a yahoo now. I know I hear a sigh. Sigh. He's just waking up from a nap in the tree that looks like a Y. Watch it now. He's up with a yell. Yahoo! Yip, 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 yip. What do you think your mother would do if you yelled like the yellow yahoo? Boo. After a yell and a tasty lunch, munch, munch, a yellow yahoo rubs his tummy. When you ask him if his lunch was good, he answers, yes, quite yummy. And then the yahoo yawns. He yawns, that yellow yahoo. Then it's up the tree and fast asleep, and then to dream about you. He dreams about you, the yellow yahoo, through the night under the sky, by the tree that looks like a Y.
Hello there. Today we're going to talk about squares, and we're going to play a little game entitled Hidden Squares. Now in this game, I'm going to show you a picture, and in the picture there's going to be some hidden squares, and you are going to have to find where the squares are. Doesn't that sound like fun? Oh, I'll tell the world. Now then, everybody remember what a square is? Well, here's a square. See that right there? Now that is a square. Now you can tell it's a square because it's got four sides and all the sides are the same length. You see that? See there? There. Like that. It's also got four corners and all the corners are exactly the same too. And that's what we call a square. Okay? Thank you. All right. Now then, for the first picture. Now right here is a picture. And this is a picture of a bus. Right? Now look at this picture of a bus and see if you can find any squares anywhere on this picture. The tires of the bus? Oh, no, no, those are not squares. No, no. What else? The headlights? Oh, that's certainly not a square, is it? Mm-mm. The front windshield is not a square. No. Where? The wheel? No, no, no. That tire is not a square either. No. Where? The window. Very good. That window is indeed square, isn't it? And that window is square. Any others? And that window is square. Very good. Mm-hmm. There were three squares on this picture, weren't there? Shall we try another one? Why not? Okay. Now here is a picture of a room. And this is sort of a living room-like picture. I think it's the room where Ernie's mother lives, because there's a picture of Ernie. Where's the square here? The lampshade? Oh, no, that's not square, no. What else might be square? The rug? No, the rug is not square. What else? The chair? No, the chair is not square. The picture of Ernie! Very good. That is indeed square. Okay, how about one more? Now, here is a picture. And this is a picture of a...
What? Hi. What you doing?
Well, we're playing a little game here entitled Hidden Squares.
Hidden Squares?
Yes.
Okay, can I play two?
You want to play two?
Wants to play Hidden Squares.
Yeah. No.
No?
No, no. We're playing a game here, and it would be very nice if you would just sit there very quietly while we play. Okay? Now, this is a picture. Don't have your feelings hurt there, I hope.
No, no, I'm okay. I will
okay,
just...
All right.
I'll listen.
Just sit quietly and you can watch us play,
okay,
right?
Okay, I'll be quiet, though.
Okay. Now, here's a picture of a box.
Of cookies.
What?
A box of cookies.
Well, it's just a picture of a box. There's no reason to believe there's any cookies in there. It's just a picture of a box.
Chocolate chip cookies.
No, it's just a picture of a box. We don't know what's in the box, you see.
Monster know what's inside box. Monster know 14 chocolate chip cookies.
Well, I suppose if you want to pretend that there are cookies in
no,
this
monster,
box,
no
it doesn't
pretend.
Matter, but
14 chocolate
we will
chip
say that there is a...
Cookies.
Why don't you be quiet?
Little...
Be quiet, please.
I'll be quiet.
Here is a picture of a box.
Of cookies.
Now, where do you suppose on this picture is a square? On the side of the
on
box?
On the side, yeah.
No,
side.
No. Oh, no, that is not true. No, no that's
not
a square.
No. On the top, on the top.
No, the top of the box is not a square either.
No, that's... No. I was wrong.
Where else might be a square?
There.
The end of the box. Why, yes, indeed, that is indeed a square.
Yeah.
Very good.
That is a square.
Okay, and that was a square.
Are you finished with game now?
Yes, the game is over now.
Can I have a box of cookies?
Well, that's not a box of cookies. That's just a picture. That's just a picture of a box of cookies.
That is a box of cookies.
No, it's not.
Hey, Pete, Reverend, where are you going? I thought you were going to sing me a song.
Well, I thought we did.
No, for me, eh?
All right, what kind would you like?
Well, you sang about almost everything. How about a song about soda?
I know a song about bottles. Will that do?
It's all right with me. Come on right in. I got a
all right.
Do it. Here, look here.
Oh.
Yeah? Now, there are bottles for you, right? Let's have the song now.
Well, I need a musical instrument. Got a box?
A box, too? No,
I need a box.
I got everything. Let's see. Oh, coming up in one moment. Here we are. Here's a box for
all
you.
All right. All right. This is just the right number, too. Six brown bottles standing on the wall. Six brown bottles standing on the wall. If one brown bottle should accidentally fall, there'll be five brown bottles standing on the wall. Five brown bottles standing on the wall. Five brown bottles standing on the wall. If one brown bottle should accidentally fall, there'll be four brown bottles standing on the wall. Four brown bottles standing on the wall. If one brown bottle should accidentally fall, there'll be three brown bottles standing on the wall. Three brown bottles standing on the wall. Three brown bottles standing on the wall. If one brown bottle should accidentally fall, there'll be two brown bottles standing on the wall. Brown bottles standing on the wall. If one brown bottle should accidentally fall, there'll be one brown bottle standing on the wall. One brown bottle standing on the wall. One brown bottle standing on the wall. If one brown bottle should accidentally fall, there'll be no brown bottle standing on the wall. No brown bottle standing on the wall.
standing on the wall. If no brown bottles should accidentally fall, there'll be no brown bottles standing on the wall.
That was marvelous. Thanks, Pink River. Thank you. Now, what could I offer you?
Bottle of soda.
Soda? We're all out of them. There we are. Hey, here's one, Reverend. Hey, Pete, here's one for you. Huh? How about you, Marty? You would like one?
Oh, thank you.
Good. Here, Marty. Quench your throat.
Cream of soda.
Thank you.
Have you ever thought about all the people that live around your neighborhood? Well, now, who are the people in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, in your neighborhood. Say, who are the people in your neighborhood? The people that you meet each day.
Hey, who could I be, Bob?
Well, if I put this little hat on you, you could be the garbage man.
Great. Oh, the garbage man works hard each day. He'll always take your trash away. I drive the biggest truck you've ever seen, and I'll make sure your streets are clean.
'Cause a garbage man's a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
He's in your neighborhood.
A garbage man's a person in your neighborhood. A person that you meet each day.
Who am I?
Well, you're the barber, but you need a barber pole.
Oh, a barber has a great big chair. You sit in it, he cuts your hair. I'll snip and clip and never rest until I make you look your best.
'Cause a barber is a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
He's in your neighborhood.
And the garbage man's a person in your neighborhood.
You tell him they're the people that you meet
when you're walking down the street. They're the people that you meet each day.
How about a little trim right here?
This is a letter. The letter Y. Do you know how I know? It looks like the trunk of a tree where the yellow yahoos go. Listen. Yahoo. There's a yahoo now. I know I hear a sigh. Sigh. He's just waking up from a nap in the tree that looks like a Y. Watch it now. He's up with a yell. Yahoo! Yip, 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 yahoo! What do you think your mother would do if you yelled like the yellow yahoo? Boo. After a yell and a tasty lunch, a yellow yahoo rubs his tummy. When you ask him if his lunch was good, he answers, yes, quite yummy. And then the yahoo yawns. He yawns, that yellow yahoo. Then it's up the tree and fast asleep, and then to dream about you. He dreams about you, the yellow yahoo, through the night under the sky, by the tree that looks like a Y.
Why?
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 Why? Yo-yo. Whoa, 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 why?
Listen, let's go see if we can find some kids to teach them a song.
Oh.
What's all this laundry doing in here?
What?
What? Take the clothespins out of your mouth. Yes. Now, what's all this laundry doing
here? Well, Mr. Lee, who does the laundry in the little store down the street, well, he wasn't feeling good, so I said I'd help him by hanging up the laundry to dry.
Oh, that's
this
very
is the
nice.
Only place I could find to put up a line. Is it all right?
Oh, sure. Why don't we help you, as a matter of fact?
Oh, you're gonna help?
Sure.
Oh, sure. Here's some more. Okay, I have the clothespins, and the kids are hanging up some clothes.
Okay, let me get back here by this line.
Okay.
Here's some. Ooh. You need some clothes. Here's some clothes.
All right. I'll sing you a song while you're working. I'll sing. We all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. We all work together with a giggle and a grin. With a wiggle and a giggle and a google and a woogle. A jiggle and a jaggle and a giggle and a grin.
Oh, I like that song.
My mama said, my papa too. All kinds of work that I can do. Dry my dishes and I sweep my floor. But if I all work together, well, it won't take long. We all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. We all work together with a giggle and a grin. With a wiggle and a giggle and a google and a woogle and a jiggle and a jaggle. A giggle and a grin. Well, Big Bird said, Susan too. All kinds of things that we can do. Pick up the clothing, hang up the wash, all do it together, well, it won't take long. We all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. We all work together with a giggle and a grin. With a wiggle and a giggle and a google and a woogle and a jiggle and a jangle and a giggle and a grin. Sister said, brother too, all kinds of things that we can do. Bring her candy, bring him gum, all good, well, it won't take long. We all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. We all work together with a giggle and a grin. With a wiggle and a giggle and a google and a woogle and a jiggle and a jaggle and a giggle and a grin. Grandma said, Grandpa too, all kinds of things that we can do.
Okay.
All do it together, it won't take long. Sing it together with one more time. All work together with a wiggle and a giggle. All work together with a giggle and a grin. With a wiggle and a giggle and a google and a google and a jiggle and a jangle and a giggle and a grin.
Together, we got a lot done really quick. You know, when you cooperate, it's a lot more fun.
Right.
I took a shower so I wouldn't be dirty. You can clean almost anything, almost everything. My sister brushes her teeth. Animals clean themselves. Some animals don't have to take a bath because they're in the water all the time. When a car gets dirty, it goes to the car wash. Mm-hmm. Where you live has to be clean too. By sweeping and vacuuming and dusting. And dishes get washed in the sink and clothes in the washing machine. Driveways get cleaned when it snows, and streets when they get dirty. And boots. You can clean almost anything, even me.
Oh! hi, brother, Pat Crick. Pete brother Seeger. Kirk. How do you say his name?
Brother Kirk.
Brother Kirk. I love to hear you sing.
Well, in that case, I guess I sang a song about love.
Yeah.
There is more love somewhere. There is more love somewhere. I'm gonna keep on till I find it. There is more love somewhere. There is more love somewhere. There is more love somewhere. I'm gonna keep on till I find it. There is more love.
Professor Hastings will show us how two things can be both the same and different. Professor Hastings. Professor.
Yeah,
what? Over here, sir.
Over there? Here.
If you would stand right over here, sir.
Yeah, yes, quite. Yeah.
A little further, sir?
Yeah.
Fine.
Hello.
Good evening.
Oh, hello. Hello, yes. Today, we are going to talk about... Excuse me, what are we going to talk about?
You were going to show us how these two trucks are the same...
No. Oh, quite wrong. They are not the same at all. They're different. Different, young man, different.
Yeah.
Yes, you see. The reason is, One is big, very big. The other is small. You see? They're not the same at all. No.
But if you'll look at the two trucks...
They... What? Two trucks? Where? Well, no, I only see one truck. Is it? Just one truck.
Here we are, Professor. Now, Professor.
Yes, I'm up. I'm up.
Lecture. Come on. Perhaps you'd rather begin by telling us how these two trucks are different.
Oh, no. You see, they're not different. No, quite no. No, they're the same. You see, they both have six wheels, you see? They are both dump trucks, are
well,
they
yes,
not?
Professor, but...
Yes, they're both red and yellow. Are they not?
Well...
I have eyes, you know.
Well, they are sort of the same.
Of course they're the same. They're my eyes.
No, Professor, the trucks... They have things that are the same, and they have things that are different.
Oh.
That's the point of your whole lecture.
The point of... Well, what is the point of my lecture?
The point of your lecture is, Professor, that the trucks are the same in some ways and different in some ways. They are the same because they are both red and yellow and have six wheels and are dump trucks. They are different... in that one is big and the other is little. Professor? Professor Hastings? Professor! This concludes today's lecture. Professor!
That is a bass clap. During the slave days, before slaves were allowed to use instruments, or before they had instruments, they used their bodies as musical instruments. And it's the same type of music we're doing today. They use it, the same register. Let us try this for example. You can take the left hand and extend it, and tap it in the heel with the right hand, and you get a very high tenor pitch. Let us try that. Right on. Then you can bring the hands together, parallel, and you get what we call the baritone pitch. Right on. Then you can cross the hands and cup it, and you get the bass pitch. Thank you. Now that's the way the music went. Let us try it all together. This is the tenor group.
Okay.
And your position will be this. Good. Baritones. Thank you. Bass. Good. All right, we're going to try it with music.
Okay.
Bass drum.
Gonna lay down my burdens down by the riverside. Study war no more. Ain't gonna study war no more.
please assist me while I demonstrate?
Huh?
Pick this up, dum-dum.
Oh, my. There.
That's right. Now that is the letter O.
Oh.
Correct. Now I'm going to recite a poem.
Oh?
Yes. The poem is about the letter called O, one of which you are holding there.
Oh.
Wonderful. A wonderful letter is O. It looks like a donut, you know. It has a round shape, like a ball or a grape, which makes it quite easy to throw.
Oh! Uh-oh.
This your O? Oh.
There. It's done. Hey, Bert, it's done.
Yeah?
Come on. Hey, Bert, it's done.
Well, what's done?
The story I just wrote.
Story?
Greatest story in the whole wide world.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, let me read it to you.
Well, is it going to take long?
Oh, no, it's just a short story, Bert.
All right, read it to me.
Okay, you're going to love this story. It's the greatest story in the world.
Yeah, just read it to me, Ernie.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Here it comes. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Now comes the sad part. H, I, J, K.
Ernie.
L, M-N-O.
Ernie.
B. Here. Now listen to this. This is the action part that starts now.
Yeah.
Q, R, S, T.
Ernie, that's
U.
The alphabet.
Oh, but listen to the wind-up. V, W, X, Y.
Well?
Well, what?
Well, finish it. Go ahead. You went U, V, W, X, Y, and you stopped there. Go ahead, finish it.
What? And tell you how the story ends? Then you'll never want to read it.
Oh.
Grow and go, roll over the road where the goat explodes all the O's and the crow flies low. Past the croaking toad and the boat floats over the ocean, but the wind did blow and it started to snow. So the toad went home to the telephone. He spoke to the goat who was eating a bowl of bones, potatoes and soap. A rope did float and hooked the goat, and the boy climbed the stone made of O's. The O's turned to smoke and started to float closer to the bulldozer, who closed up the hole so the cold wind could not blow, and the sun did show so the roses could grow, and the whole world would know that the boat bulldozer, the toad and the crow, the boy and the rope, right and the goat, were all okay. Okay.
Oh. Open. Oh. Open. 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 Oh.
Oh, wow. Hey, you know what time it is?
What time is it?
It's time to say goodbye. Hey, you got a goodbye song for us?
Yeah.
Have you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now is the time for us to say goodbye. Soon we'll be leaving. We're in the way. While we are away, oh, please remember us. We'll be back one of these days to make more of this good old fuss.
Yeah, hey,
now is the time for us to say goodbye. Soon we'll be leaving, pouring away.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letter O, and by the letter Y, and by the number 3.
Thank you.
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.